van life. Is it safe?
In this video, we're gonna talk about whether or not van life is safe. And I'm not just gonna definitively tell you it is or it isn't. I'm just gonna lay it all out there and maybe give you some things that you've never considered. And at the end of this video, well, you can make your own informed decision. So yeah, let's get right into it. Is van life safe? First, consider this. Let's say you're from a certain area and you've lived there for a very long time. So you know it really well. You're essentially a local. And you know which parts of that area are better than others, which parts of the town might be kind of sketchy, maybe even deeper than that, which individuals, you know, people you know in town that are up to really good things and people that are, well, maybe even kind of shady or up to things that just aren't on the up and up. But when you're in a van, living out of it, constantly cruising around, going to new areas, and just putting yourself in places you're really not that familiar with, you could inadvertently be putting yourself in harm's way and not even know it because you're not familiar with the area. But in a lot of ways, that's something that makes it kind of cool too. You're constantly just getting out of your comfort zone and experiencing new things. But it could also be something that is kind of dangerous. Also, if you go to a small town, you might stick out like a sore thumb because people have never seen you there before. Everybody knows that you're probably living in your van and you're just traveling through. Good people, maybe not so good people. It's really hard to say. Something to consider. The next thing I want to bring up is there's two different styles of van living. There's essentially two different strategies. There's two different kinds of people that live in their vans. There's people that prefer stealth camping in town. The kind of person that is working a 9-to-5 job or likes to shower at a gym every single day or just simply likes to be close to infrastructure or family or whatever it may be. And then there's people that like to boondock. They like to be way outside of cities, not near anybody. They haul all their own stuff, everything they need, they brought with them, including water and food and, you know, all that stuff. But they don't like to be super close to other people. And these two different styles are kind of like a Venn diagram. They can intersect at any time. Like somebody living the stealth city life could go straight out to the boonies the next week, and they could switch it up at any moment. But I'm mentioning this and it's important because something to remember, cities have a lot more people, which means they have a lot more good people, but they also have a lot more bad people. So the chance of something happening to you in the city, you know, is higher. It's a higher probability that someone will break into your van or something, you know, someone can hit your van while you're sleeping in it or just something overall that you don't want to happen. The probability is just simply higher. And that's something a lot of people don't consider. Some people automatically assume that rural areas and being way outside of civilization is more dangerous. And I suppose it can be in certain ways, but overall, I think it's something that, in my opinion, is a lot safer. Shameless merch plug. Available on Teespring. Link is in the description. Anyway, on to the next thing. The kind of van you have is also telling to what kind of people you might run into out on the road that might be trying to take advantage of you. And yeah, not everybody's trying to take advantage of you. And what I'm about to say here is not only from my experience, but it's from what I've learned from other people from talking to them about their experiences as well. So if you have a really expensive $100,000 Sprinter or Ram ProMaster completely built out, chances are people are gonna be trying to rob you. That van just screams, I got money, and people might be trying to take advantage of you in that manner. Versus a van like this, or like a Chevy Express, you know, I ran into a lot of hitchhikers, which was fine, but a lot of the hitchhikers I ran into were either really, really drunk, or they were just really aggressively trying to negotiate rides with me. And what was really inconvenient about that, and kind of sketchy at times, is they always came at, you know, at like right before dark, where I was like, settling down to sleep in a certain area, and someone would pop their head in because I'd be cooking dinner or something and be like, hey man, I need a ride to here. And it's like, all right, dude, well, I'm not going anywhere. And I don't know, just something about that was just kind of unsettling and at times made me a little uneasy. So it's something to definitely consider. If you have a really expensive van, you're going to attract that kind of attention. And if you have a cheaper van like mine, you might attract more of that kind of attention. So something to consider. Anyway, next let's talk about injuries. Let's say you get injured while living in your van, which could be really, really bad for a couple reasons. If you got a dog with you and, you know, you have to go to the emergency room, what do you do with your dog? Does he stay in the van unsupervised? What if it's hot? You can't do that. Or let's say there's no cell service where you are. You're boondocking. You're in a really remote area. You get injured and you're by yourself living in your van. What do? Do you just limp it into town with like your arm hanging off? I don't know. It's definitely, you know, getting injured could be something that could be really, really bad for a couple reasons. So yeah, something to consider. I'll stop saying that, I promise. Something to consider.
Oh yeah, well consider this. I'm leaving a thumbs down on your video, bro.
And last and definitely not least, you have an extremely powerful superpower when you're living in your van. You have the power of avoidance. You can just jump in the front seat and drive away at any time. And honestly, it's something that's kind of beautiful, and it's something that is not an option when you're living in a sticks and bricks house. You either gotta just stand your ground and defend your turf, or run away and risk injury, I guess. But in a van, you could just hop in the front seat and just go, ha-ha, toodaloo. So that's something I think is really, really awesome. Now let's get into the safety of inanimate objects, the security of your stuff. You like your stuff, right? You want to keep it, of course. Something to consider. There's a lot of different clever ways to protect your stuff, because if you're truly living in your vehicle, everything you own is inside with you. Unless you got like a storage unit or something, but chances are if you're living in your car, your van, your truck, whatever, all your worldly possessions are inside with you. And some of them, they're really expensive and really important. So you want to make it just that much harder for someone to pull an old smash and grab and steal all your stuff while you're just in the grocery store or wherever else. I think having an alarm system is pretty critical. It just makes it that much more of a scene if someone tries to steal your stuff. Also, a lot of people like to talk about security cameras recently and all that, but to have a proper security system, you need it to be connected to Wi-Fi. So unless you're just mooch-docking, camping out in your buddy's driveway 24/7, or, you know, just out in front of a place you work all the time, you're not gonna have Wi-Fi to properly run security cameras inside your van 24/7. It's just not realistic. But you can run different cable locks to secure your stuff, but overall, you know, and sure, you could get renter's insurance, but overall, it's just kind of, when you're living the van life, your stuff is somewhat at risk when you're not around. So, something to consider. So, is van life safe? I don't know. What do you think? I kind of laid it all out there. Whether you're living in your van now, or it's something you're considering, I hope maybe you gained some insight and, you know, heard some stuff that you've maybe never thought about or maybe never heard about before. And that's all I'm trying to do here. I don't want to dissuade anybody that's thinking about getting into this life due to this video and some of the cons, because the pros are plentiful. And they're often way over glorified here on this space known as the internet. So I just kind of wanted to bring it real, bring it raw, and kind of just tell you how it is. Anyway, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you dislike this video, leave a like anyway. I'd greatly appreciate it. And yeah, I'm actually thinking about selling this van too. I still gotta figure some stuff out, but I'm really in the market for a four-wheel drive diesel truck. I think it'd be way more capable, way more awesome, way more versatile, and I wanna put a removable truck bed camper in the back eventually. But that's a whole nother video. Thank you so much for watching. It really does mean a lot to me, and I'll see you guys this Wednesday. And if you're new to the channel, I post Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. That is all. Thanks for watching.